something on TikTok here, and I was like, oh, let me shoot. Some nigga build he's
I'm busy right now, please. I have to work on this thing, this document, and submit it as soon as possible. I'm busy.
You are always forcing to get to the top, meanwhile you are still in the same position.
Forcing to get to the top.
You are still in the same position.
What?
We'll be sitting here now, then we'll come and start.
What are you trying to insinuate?
I see what you are doing.
So I shouldn't work? Why are you acting like that? We're from all that.
Just continue what you are doing already. I have time to.
Hello, ladies. I need you in my office within the next 5 minutes.
Yes, I do.
We are here, boss.
You may have a seat.
Thank you.
I just want to put something before you. That this company is on the verge of winning a contract from a group of investors. So what we have to do is we have to do our very best in branding this company to seize our investors. And so greater work for life or greater responsibilities will be on you too. Okay. So you have to sell or showcase this company for them to be able to buy whatever ideas we have as a company. Do you understand? But what I have come to realize from these investors is that it goes beyond office work ceremony. It goes beyond office work, meaning you don't really have to rely on what you do here. You have to go the extra mile in pleasing them. And when I talk of pleasing them, I assume you guys understand because you are adults. And so, you have to go the extra mile in pleasing them. Do you get it?
You mean we've landed a deal? We are about to land a deal?
Yes.
That's what it means.
So, you will have to work overtime with these people as well. I mean, even if only them taking you out after working hours, you should be able to comply. Even if you go to the extent of taking you to bed or whatsoever, you should be able to comply because this company needs the deal. Likewise, you guys, because we are talking about $200 million involved in this deal. If we are to get this deal, your salary also goes up.
But sir, giving up my body is against my morals. I can't do that.
Okay, so you are here to talk about morals, right? Can I ask you a question? Was it your morals that got you into this company?
My hard work.
Your hard work.
Yeah.
Okay, so I would also want you to go the extra mile to work hard in managing this team.
But working hard is not about.
And I'm not going to take any contribution or suggestion from you again. It's either you do this or you find a way out. Charity. I hope you understand all that I have told you guys.
Yes, boss.
Yes, so for you, I trust you very well. Mm-hmm. I know your determination and your desire to work. So I know you were going to go that extra mile.
Oh, yes.
Sarah, bear in mind that if you lose this deal, you are going home. Thank you. You can now leave my office.
Thank you.
Charity, come back. Sarah, I can go. So, I know what you are, the things you can do very well. So I want you to do your very best when these people come. Left to that girl alone, you will lose this deal. But I'm putting my trust in you. And when it comes for any layoff in this company, I'll make sure your name is exempted.
Yes.
Your name is taken off. And if there is a promotion, I will use my position and my authority in this company to promote you. Just get out of this job and then you are better off. Thank you.
Thank you. Have a nice day.
Mirrors. You see, when this big deal came, the boys didn't give it to you because you are always talking about.
I don't even need.
Are you the only person that wants to stay chased? What?
What I told you?
Something that's going to bring money to the company won't spoil it. Hey!
That's your choice, and that's my choice.
I
choose to do what I want. I'm not going to sell my body for something like this.
Of course, yes. I'll do it. So that's the company who get the money. And when it comes,
you're doing it for the company.
You see me in a high position, madam. You don't know me from anywhere. I'm scared.
Okay.
You're highly welcome once again.
Thank you.
In fact, I'm a very happy man today. You guys did extremely a very good job. Charity, a very big congratulations to you.
Thank you.
You did a very good job for the company.
Thank you.
And to Samira, well, what else can I say? You want to say thank you. But anyway, I'll maybe come to you on that later. But hey girls, we're going to mount the deal. And I'm so grateful on behalf of the LSC. I want to say a very big thank you to you. Thank you very, very much for putting us through this. Okay. So we can get back to your work, whatever information that pops up. I'll let you know. Samira, you can take the lead while she goes.
Thank you.
Charity. Don't worry. As I promised you, I'll be so
okay. Thank you.
There will be many of people who are by the end of the day. But then, I promise you, I do the things you can do. Just as you know, I'll do my best.
Thank you. similar.
Yeah.
When you entered your pastor, did they come?
Yeah.
Why is mine not coming? I'm not getting access. Why?
Maybe you should relax and do it.
No. Because I'm supposed to get access that instant I put in my password.
Good morning, Mr. Lovin. I'm very good, sir. Yes, please, sir. Yes, please, I'm at office. One of the ladies who fought hard for us to end the deal is complaining that she's unable to log on to the system. Yes. Charity mentor, yes, please. No, sir. Per names, I wasn't expecting her to be part because, aside all that, she's also hardworking. And nothing can be done about it. So please. Okay. I'm going to tell you that it is the CEO himself who has deactivated your card. And he was telling me that anybody whose card is not working or unable to log on to the system has been laid off. Of which I don't really understand what is happening now.
But how could this happen? Because you told me you would help me in every way you could. So why did you allow this to happen?
I'm so sorry. This is me. It was the investor's report that the CEO acted upon. And so you happened to be laid off as well. I'm so, so sorry.
But how could this happen? How? Because you told me you would help me. How could this happen?
I understand what you are going through now. I understand your grievances and everything. I promised you I was going to do my very best for you. But honestly, I never saw this coming.
You don't understand. You do not understand. You made me put my body on the line for this deal.
To be laid off. I understand. But that wasn't the plan then. It was never planned or rehearsed. I wish I could help, but honestly, it is a CEO, and it goes beyond me, like I've told you already. There is little or nothing I can do about this. I'm sorry. I had to call the head of IT to find out, and he even told me that this is what is happening. And you were here when I called the CEO. I'm so sorry, but then there is nothing I can do about it.